Hello everyone. Now we are going to do the fourth skill, which is the skill of blackboard. Now the skill of blackboard work is very important because in our classes we will have people who learn in different styles, like people who learn through audio, people who learn through video, people who learn by doing, people who learn by imagination. We have different types of learners in our class, but the traditional way of learning is the visual style. And in a class of maybe 60 children, at least 35 to 40 children would be visual learners because of our traditional way of learning. Now, the skill of blackboard is very important because if the student fails to listen to you while you deliver something, the student will be able to catch up by watching whatever is written on the board. So while we teach, we should also engage in board work, like simple drawings, writing down certain words, drawing a flow chart. All this will help actually to build visual memory in the child. Now, looking at the first component, we should write very clearly distinct letters, meaning no overlapping, keeping your letters very congested. And your letters should be very visible for the child from the first row to the child seated at the last bench. While you write the first line on the board, and you can walk around your class to check if your children are, ready, if they have their pencils or pens ready, and if they are really writing. So while you walk around, you can go and take the position right at the end of the class, and you can check whether your writing is straight, whether it's clear, or whether the font size is too small or too big. So that check you must make always when you do line one. Then you come back, so the student knows teacher is walking around and I cannot be without writing. So you come forward. Then neatness. So when you write, they see the blackboard, children should feel very organized, very neat. So they would try to keep their notebooks very neat. For example, on the corner of the board, you need to have the number present, number absent. On this corner, you will have the date written. In the center, you will have the name of the lesson which you're particularly doing on that day. And of course, important words, or important flowchart, or little diagrams. And even when you draw, instead of just drawing and say, this is leaves, this is tree, without even writing, you just say and you keep rushing. So at the end of it, how does this look? Doesn't look like a figure at all. So instead, you write the word, this is a tree. While you explain, take a minute to write. So the children understand, okay, the teacher was in a hurry, but this she actually meant to draw a tree. And you might have some children, being a little naughty and say, teacher doesn't know to draw a tree. So we should accept all that with a smile. So instead of rushing and drawing that tree so horribly, draw it out neatly, so which is like acceptable to the child. All right. And then the straight lines, especially when you're doing math, when you're doing concepts which dealing with angles, 90 degrees, 60 degrees, take the effort to take the big geometry box, the wooden box to your classes, measure, draw. Just don't do freehand drawing. You do freehand drawing and you tell your child, measure for 5 centimeter, measure 30 degrees. No, you have to replica. Do what is required so the child is actually copying you. Children are like wet cement. The impression you give, that is formed. That is forever. We cannot undo that. Then what you can do is, instead of writing the same color, you can use variation. For certain aspects, you can use red chalk. For certain, you can use blue. For certain, you can use green. Go with a nice creative concept of doing your board. And the last one is appropriate blackboard work. Example, continuity of ideas, drawing attention of the student in a systematic way. Now, let me give you the same example as the lesson which I was just explaining, Balu and the apple tree. The first sequence, the first sacrifice the tree made was the apple. The second sacrifice was the branch. This is the leaves. What was the third sacrifice? It was the stump. The next sacrifice was the roots. So this is one, this is two, this is three, this is four. And who used all this? Balu. So it was Balu so erect when he used the root? No. How was Balu in this position? He must have been like this because he took the branches and he built a house. Then Balu was slightly old when he wanted to go and see the world. So he wanted to make a boat to go and enjoy himself. And Balu was very much, very old, bent up, like our grandparents at home, very bent, very small, when he wanted to just rest his back. So, but now by seeing this diagram, the child is able to, it looks a little puzzled, but however, the child is able to connect with the lines which I have drawn. So very old, he wanted this. When he was a little of a medium age, he wanted the boat. When he was very young, he wanted the branches. And then when he was very small, he wanted the apple. So you can ask the child to draw the concept in a different way, use colors. You yourself can actually color this with red, color this with brown. That's how you make your blackboard a very interactive kind of visual learning to your child.